This episode is brought to you by ayahuasca. Hey there, day trippers. Jules here for D News. In 1971, Richard Nixon started what many call the war on drugs in the United States, cracking down on illegal narcotics and, quote, tightening the noose around the necks of drug peddlers. The same year, the United Nations enacted a treaty designed to ban psychotropic substances. Nonetheless, a number of illegal drugs can, were, and are still used recreationally and as medicine. And one of the most widely debated categories of drugs in this respect is psychedelics. Just to be clear, a psychedelic is a drug which most often works by activating serotonin receptors, causing changes in cognition and perception. This is similar to the effects found in activities like meditation, dreaming, and even having a near-death experience. And in fact, this dramatic shift in perception is not necessarily a bad thing. For centuries, psychedelics have been used in medical treatments and religious ceremonies. Native Americans have used and continue to use psychotropic cactuses called peyote, which contain a chemical called mescaline. Anecdotally, it's a successful treatment for alcoholism and other addictions. The indigenous people of Mexico's preferred religious drug is psilocybin mushrooms. And in South America, a drink called ayahuasca contains a very strong hallucinogen called DMT. And while the merits of drug use are up for debate, we at DNews certainly don't encourage you to experiment, the fact that they're illegal means that these claims are incredibly difficult to verify. Until very recently, many illegal drugs were also effectively impossible to legally procure for scientists to study. So while politicians can demonize all drugs as the same, science has been unable to fire back with much proof. Although the 1950s through the 1970s saw a flurry of government-sponsored studies on LSD and other psychedelics, many were dismissed as unscientific or done illegally in secret. One study in 1969 did find that when autistic and schizophrenic children were given LSD and psilocybin, they consistently found improved speech behavior in mute children, increased emotional responsiveness, happier moods, and less compulsive behavior. And some researchers have found clever ways to study the effects of psychedelics without actually having them. In 2012, two Norwegian scientists did a meta-analysis of existing studies on LSD use and alcoholism. These studies were completed between 1966 and 1970, before the United Nations called for the global ban. Essentially, the scientists were examining the progress of alcoholics at inpatient clinics, some of whom were given a small dose of LSD. The researchers found that 59% of those who had taken it decreased their alcohol consumption, compared to 38% of those patients who did not take LSD. Additionally, they found that the LSD patients were 15% more likely to stay sober after leaving the clinic. In recent years, more and more studies have been able to be performed with psychedelics, particularly psilocybin mushrooms. One ongoing study out of NYU is looking at their effects to treat cancer patients with anxiety. For many terminal patients, providing palliative care can be of the utmost importance, and it's been shown that psychedelics do seem to ease this form of anxiety. In the past few years, several other studies have shown that psilocybin can introduce a mystical or spiritual experience, which can be a method of dealing with cancer patients' psychosocial distress. And in a more recent study released in 2015, Brazilian researchers gave patients with depression the drink ayahuasca. They found that not only did their depression decrease almost immediately, but that it remained that way for the following few weeks. To be absolutely fair, the study has little external validity, as the sample size was only 6 volunteers and there was no control group to compare to. Of course, the difficulty in studying psychedelics hasn't stopped people from self-medicating outside of an appropriate scientific and medical setting. This can lead to less than optimal reactions and adverse effects. So, although we here at DNews can't in good conscience promote drug use, we do promote scientific research. So in that light, I say, let's legalize psychedelics for science. Some of the biggest drug users in the world are rats, because we test drugs on rats. And if you're interested in other stuff about rats, like the life of rats, check out this documentary on Discovery Go called Rats. Download the Discovery Go app for free in your app store or check out the link below to learn more. Interestingly, scientists still don't completely understand how and why psychedelics affect the brain. But you can hear about some of those ideas on LSD and its effects on the brain in this video right here. So what do you think? Should psychedelics be made legal to study? Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to DNews for more episodes every day.